Cassie Easton collects miracles. Cassie does collect miracles. Babies pulled alive out of garbage cans. Grandmothers who give birth to twins. Old men blind for decades who blink and regain their sight. Miracles. She tears articles out of the paper, makes notes on things mentioned on late night television. Soldiers who lay down their guns and drug dealers who burn their stash. Pregnant women buried in earthquakes who climb out alive a week later with a newborn in their arms. Barren women who become pregnant. Pregnant women who mysteriously disappear the babies. Miracles. Seems like a lot of miracles were about babies. Babies rescued, babies recovered, babies anticipated, found or revealed. Children, of course, miraculous in all contexts. And cripples. Cripples are pretty much always miraculous. Cripples who regain the use of limbs or senses or somehow magically learn to do without or develop an attitude. Possibly the most miraculous is a newborn baby cripple. Just invites astonishment left by gasping breath.
Patrice suddenly seemed distracted. I should tell you something. I'm used to this moment arising, what gay man isn't, so I tried to make it easier for him. We always play safe, I said, if you mean that you're positive. He shook his head. No, it's just something else. He waited for the penny to drop. I do your mama's hair. This simply did not compute. Ben looked at him, up at him, completely open-mouthed. Well, almost as open-mouthed as yes as he'd been a moment earlier. What? He murmured. I do his mama's hair, Patrice repeated, at the Gospel Palms. In this moment of raw revelation, my mind raced back to my mother's room at the rest home in Orla Vista, and the obvious pride she had shown in her smart new pastel do.
I knew it could only get better and better. All sexuality, anything we could imagine would not only be okay, but embraced. All dope made legal. Enough of everything for everybody and life getting wilder and wilder and freer shit. I hate nostalgia. I think it's disgusting. Just want to say thanks. No, that's not true. That's bullshit. What I want to say is I want it back. Total, unconditional, no consequences, all out, loving, making love like conversation, like some weird explorative journey up some Nile River, fucking, flying, playing, making it up, eating a whole necklace of LSD, and no side effects, no morning after, ever.
Arnie, baby, could you just hold on a little longer, at least until the dancers come? And Arnie replied, Bill, I'll try, but I'm ready to go, Bill. I'm ready to go now. On the last day of his life, Arnie, from amongst the crisp white of his sheets, the steely blue silver of his sick bed, across the hush of his last morning, turned to his nurse, Tom, and exclaimed, Tom, I'm sicker than I thought I was. I'm never gonna get well, am I? And Tom replied, Arnie, move towards the light, baby. Just let go, move towards the light. I got shoes, you got shoes. On the last day of his life, that's what Arnie did. Arnie moved towards the light. Arnie, seeing beyond the day, out past the windows, out into the air, began to move to the other side. And there, Bill. Bill, look, there, Bill. Bill, look, there, Bill. There's a light at the mouth of the river, Billy. And Daddy, my Daddy, who had been dead for 10 long years, Arnie sees Daddy. Arnie says, Bill, Daddy's waiting. Daddy's waving to me, Bill. Bill, I want to go now. He struggles to dance. We watch amazed, for Arnie had taken us to the edge of his great getting up morning, there in the little house, in the woods, amid scenes of a rich, full life, a life we all shared. Arnie made his last offering, a shining glimpse of Zion. And you can tell him that you're going to a party. be high as a kite. And it's gonna be all right. In shining memory of Arnie Zane and Estella, my mother, thank you.